a wise man, according to Jesus, is the man that hears the word of God and he puts it into practice. It's not going to do you any good at all just to hear the truth and reject it. You must repent. You must turn from sin. Turn from the bars. No drunkard will escape hell. All premarital sex will damn you. The only safe sex is in the confines of a legitimate marriage in God's sight. All sex outside of a legitimate marriage will send you to hell. It doesn't matter if your friends are doing it. It doesn't matter if your mother or father are shacked up. God's word says all the sexually immoral will be lost. We're talking about eternity. Where will you spend eternity? Are you willing to make a stand for Jesus? He said if you're ashamed of him, he'll be ashamed of you. And if you disown him before others, he'll disown you before the Father. There is no eternal security. Listen to me, Calvinist. Are you listening? There is no eternal security. The scriptures say in Hebrews 3:14, we've come to share in Christ if we hold firm to the end the confidence we've had at first. Is that you? Many go to college and they lose their faith.
Yes, yes.
Because of the ungodly professors and the skeptics and the sin that's in the area. Listen to me, folks. What you got to do is make a stand for truth. Stand for truth. And the truth is the Word of God. The truth is Jesus. He's alive. He's real.
Guys, we're having an event on campus this weekend. It's called the Sprite Step Off.
Follow him.
We're going to have Lupe Fiasco performing.
Yeah, you all your people. Just
check us out, guys.
Drink condoms.
Listen, guys.
Amen. Amen.
Make your life God for God. Make your life God for God. Don't let sin ruin your life. Don't let sin ruin your life. You get ensnared in drugs. You get ensnared in premarital sex. You get ensnared with drunkenness. People become alcoholics. They ruin their life in college. Don't let that happen to you. Go the God route. Don't be ashamed. Make your life count for God. Jesus is alive. And unless you repent,
Sylvia,
you'll perish. Repent or you will perish. Heaven or hell, eternity. Where will you spend eternity?
Guys, we're here now. We're here now. Right, step one. We're here.
Jesus said that if you're ashamed of him,
come on out to the Sprite Step Off. Saturday at the intramural fields. Come on out.
I'm following Jesus. Hallelujah.
We're on the same team, guys.
Same team. The Holy same team. One of God.
Sprite Step Off over at the intramural fields.
Wait, that's what I need to ask you about.
Oh, sure.
Where you got the tickets from?
Jesus. Oh, it'll be over there.
To let him dragging you to hell.
What if you're Jewish?
There's only one hope. If you're Jewish, if you're Muslim, if you're Buddhist, if you're Catholic, there's only one hope. You gotta become a Christian. You gotta repent. Put your faith in the Lamb of God who died on a cross and he rose again. I remember after I graduated from college, before I made a solid stand on the Word of God, I wanted to know for sure that it really was the Word of God. And unlike probably some of you here, I looked into the evidence. And folks, now listen to me. It's mathematically impossible for the Bible not to be the word of God because of fulfilled prophecy. It's impossible for the Bible not to be of divine inspiration. It's not like the Quran. It's not like the Book of Mormon or the Bhagavad Gita, the Angus, the Avesta. The Bible is the proven word of God, and it works. It'll set the captive free. If you're addicted to drugs, it'll set you free. It'll set you free from alcoholism, from porn addiction. The message is Jesus. Repent. Make your life count for God. If you were to die today, where would you go?
Hey man, you should take this.
In a casket.
No purgatory. The grave is not the end. We're talking eternity. We're talking you having a soul that will one day either enter God's presence or that soul will be cast into the lake of fire. Eternity. Where will you spend eternity? 500 years from now and 500 billion years from now, where will you be? The grave is not the end. The grave is not the end. And folks, know this.
God, we're having the Sprite Festival tomorrow at the Intramural Fields.
Or person
with, Lupe Fiasco
is worth going to hell over.
We have different step teams, like four fraternities, four
sorority. I said no sin.
What do you think? Is that something you might go for?
Don't try to seek the favor of the people
on campus. No, I'm just seeking you for the Sprite Step Off.
Don't try to get their acceptance.
I'm trying to get you there.
Folks, what you got to do.
What you got to do is come to the Sprite Step Off, God.
Narrow path.
You got to come to the Sprite Step Off. The narrow path will take you right there.
Jesus.
This isn't in the Bible, but the path will get you right there. Seriously,
it's right
step off, guys.
It's
the real deal.
Hey, folks, listen to this.
This guy
the Bible says the preaching of the cross is foolishness to those that are perishing. There's a prime example. The preaching of the cross is foolishness to those that are perishing. If you think this message is foolish, it's dumb. It's stupid. It's absurd. It's ludicrous. Folks, the Bible says you are in a perishable condition. If you really are a Christian, have you been making a stand for the Lord? Are you ashamed of Him? If you're a friend of this world, you're an enemy of God. Have you been going out to the bars and thinking you're a Christian? Have you been raised once saved, always saved? Are you drinking the booze and smoking the cigarettes and professing to be God's child? Do not be deceived. You're not God's child. You're a child of the devil. You're serving the enemy. You're not serving the king. There is no such thing called once saved, always saved. Calvinism's not true.
I have a question here.
Do not be deceived. Folks, are you reading your book to study for your finals?
I have a question.
This is how you study.
Question.
Go ahead.
What's the Bible? Which Bible do you follow?
Said is a lie.
Which
the
Bible?
Word of God, the 66 books of the Bible.
How about, is it
39 Hebrew
cool flyers,
books
flyers.
And 27 Greek New Testament.
So is it King John?
No, not
the King.
It doesn't have to be. This is not King James.
Have you read other books, like the Mormon's book? Or have you read it?
The Book of Mormon is from the devil.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't want the Book of Mormon. You don't want the Quran.